What's up, sons? It's Blind Rod with Simon Tech once again, and today we're going to be taking a look at the NZXT H710i. It's not a brand new case, but it's new to me. It's the first time I've built into it, and the goal of this video is to go over what it includes and help you make an informed decision. This is especially true because the case runs around $180, and there are a ton of options, both a little bit above that that you may want to consider, as well as even under that that you may want to consider too. Now, NZXT is kind of known for making everything simple, and they haven't failed to do that with this particular case either. There are a ton of good options here. They're going to make it really easy for you to build and come out with a really clean build. Cable management is fantastic, as well as all of the included features, which we're going to go over right now. Starting things off, if you take a look at the front panel, you're going to have your typical USB-C, a single one, as well as two USB type A. They are 3.0 or 3.1. supported, and all of those are going to run down with the connections to your motherboard, making it super easy to get that front IO working. It does have a power button, but no reset button, and it does have your audio jack with an included adapter in case you need to split your mic as well as your headset in. So it doesn't have a separate mic and headphone input, but it comes with the adapter to convert that over if you have a particular device that needs that support. So good on them for including it. So let's talk about airflow a little bit. This case is going to have some more airflow, or significantly more airflow, than the little brother, the 510. And that's because you're going to be able to fit three 120 millimeter fans up in the front, as well as up to a 60 millimeter thick radiator if you're doing a custom loop, which is quite impressive. It does have a front fan filter as well, and it includes with it 320 millimeter fans. Now, these fans are a little bit louder than what I would prefer, so I'd probably swap them out. If you are spending this amount of money, you're probably going to end up using them. The only disappointment here is that while it does include an RGB controller and two RGB strips, the fans that are included with the case are not RGB. There is an additional 140 millimeter fan in the rear, and it's the loudest fan in the case, coming in at over 30 decibels when fully cranked. Now, another great addition to this case that some of the other little brothers of it do not have is that it does have an option for a vertical mount GPU. Of course, you'll have to get a PCIe extender cable if you're planning on using that feature. So keep that in mind if you're ordering it and wanting that case to be out in the front. If you are going air cooled, I wouldn't recommend it, because you're going to hinder some of your airflow with that side panel, especially since it's glass with no kind of holes or any kind of airflow allowed through it. But if you're doing a liquid cooled build, it may be a viable option that you want to look into. Now, as stated before, it does have very good cable management with a ton of Velcro on the backside, and your typical routing for things like your 24 pin, even all the way to your 8 pin CPU power. And it makes it really, really easy to cable manage and make the back look really well. But it's not that big of a deal too, because the backside is going to be covered up by its panel, which is released with an easy release button that you press and it pops right out. It comes in super handy with, of course, making any changes to cable management, or if you need to install new parts or a new power supply. And I did really like that design. The other side panel, which is a glass side panel, is held in with one thumb screw and three kind of push-in pins. So you will have to pop it off, and don't be scared to kind of pull on it, because it'll kind of do that doo-doop on three little pins there, and then you'll have that side off. The GPU clearance goes up to 413 millimeters. And you can have a CPU cooler up to as tall as 185 millimeters. Like we stated before, you have a front rad support of 360 millimeters by 60 millimeters thick, and a top rad support of 360 millimeters up to 30 millimeters thick. So plenty of water cooling options available here. You could even mount 140 millimeter rad on the back too, if you really wanted to go overkill. Two 360 millimeter fans should take care of that, no problem. Finally, if you're talking about reservoir and pump, you get to have up to a 224 millimeter height. So you can't go up to that 300 millimeter reservoir, but it does support that along the cable bar, and it's integrated support. So you'll have an easy time doing a custom loop in this case. Now, the build we did in this case was not a custom loop. Everything was just plug and play. So it was as simple as just installing everything. We went with the Kraken X63 280 millimeter all-in-one, and that plugged right up into all the supported RGB controllers, which then we could plug into the MSI motherboard and sync everything through there. The Sapphire graphics card that we had as well went straight in, no problem, and plugged into the MSI motherboard that we supported, and the lighting was on point. There wasn't any additional lights that we had to add to get sufficient lighting, because even though the fans didn't have the RGB on them, the two strips were laid out so well that there was very clear to see into the case and see all of the components in the case. So very impressive with their placement, and it made everything super easy. Building in it is also super easy. We already talked about the back side panel and the front side panel and their removal process. You can also remove the front panel by grabbing onto the bottom and popping it out, and that will also reveal the air filter for you to clean. And then once the front panel's off, you can take top panel off in the same manner by grabbing the handle and pulling up, and that will reveal the 360 millimeter radiator or fan mount that you can actually remove and install the radiator in separate and then place it back into the case. Now, the cable management bar that we've talked about before, and also is where you would mount your custom pump and reservoir if that's what you were planning on doing, is kind of obtrusive when trying to deal with the 24 pin power. If you're going to be doing custom cables, usually you like to show that off. And unfortunately, with that cable management bar there, it kind of tucks funny. And I still don't know that I really like their implementation of the cable management bar there. But, you know, that's a take it or leave it thing and a personal preference, so that's really going to be up to you. Some of the other cases you might want to take into account when looking at this is something like the Corsair 500D, which would have tempered side panels on both the front and back that open up with a hinge and are very easy to access, and does feel quite a bit more hefty than the H710i. That doesn't mean you shouldn't go with the NZXT option. It just means it's something to consider, because a lot of these things are going to be very, very subjective, the way it looks and so on. So, like I said, my point here was to give you guys all of the features of the NZXT H700i so you can make your own decision. I'm curious what you think about this case and its viability, and if you're interested in building it at any point, down in the comment section below. I'm still streaming over on Twitch every day. Every day, 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. Central Standard Time at twitch.tv/blindrun. Link will be in the description as well, so go check me out over there. Hope to see you there, and I'm glad to be back and doing some more tech content. So if you enjoy that as well, be sure to hit the sub button and the like button and click on those notifications. Until later, I will see you next Tuesday.